Namaste. Om Ityekaksharam Brahma Vyaharan Mamanusmaran. This is a shloka from Bhagavad Gita. Om Ityetadaksharamidam Sarvam Tasyopavyakhyanam. This is a mantra from Mandukya Upanishad. Tasya Vachakaha Pranavaha Tajjapaha Tadarthabhavanam. This is a sutra from Patanjali's Yoga Sutras. Now, all these three excerpts from our ancient Indian scriptures are talking about one common thing, that is Om and its meaning. Now, we in general are, at least as yoga practitioners or yoga students or general public, are kind of aware of Om as a mantra to chant. Okay, if not anywhere else, we use it at the beginning and in the end of our asana practice. But how many of us actually are aware of the significance of that chanting? Or how many of us are aware of the very meaning of Omkara? Well, to answer all of that itself is the subject matter of this particular video. Now, to begin with, what is Omkara? Omkara is not just a mantra that we are supposed to chant, neither it is only a syllable or a letter that belongs to Sanskrit language. In fact, it's the other way around. Your Sanskrit language belongs to Omkara. It has its source in Om. Okay? In fact, every language in this universe, human language or the language of the animal, or every sound, every vibration that is perceivable or beyond our perception, everything, all of that have their origin in Omkara. In fact, according to Mandukya Upanishad, every aspect of this creation is Omkara. Anything that's visible to us, or that's cognizable to us, or anything that comes within the purview of our sensory perception, all of that belongs to Omkara. That's how much inclusive and expansive the syllable, if that's what we can call it, the syllable Om stands for. And the meaning of Om, well, everything in this world has a name, and or everything in this world is designated by a word which we call as noun. So whenever you hear that noun, an object that corresponds to this noun comes automatically to your mind, spontaneously to your mind. Okay. Now, similarly, Omkara also stands for something that is equal to its own meaning. You know, that is Ishvara. Ishvara is not just the God of in human form like Lord Sri Rama or Sri Krishna, or not even the gods that are present in the temples. All of them are actually the physical or energetical manifestation of the Supreme Consciousness. And Omkara represents or denotes that Supreme Consciousness, because the supremacy of that consciousness is so much that it is beyond the time, beyond form, beyond every other experience. Okay, it's more pervasive. It's all pervasive. It knows everything. It is present everywhere. It has been present in all the frame of time. That's how much expansive Ishvara is. Now, to denote that, we cannot use a word from a particular language which is limited to a particular country or religion or a region. Okay, such comprehensive entity or the form of consciousness also requires a comprehensive word that can denote it very effectively. That's why the meaning of Omkara is Ishvara. Now, to go ahead, what is the significance of chanting Omkara? There are many significances that I can go on listing. Very important three are: the first one, Om is one of those words which are recognized by the scriptures as to be very auspicious sound. So whenever we begin something new, okay, something, whenever we start afresh, if we begin it with Omkara, it would be a very auspicious beginning. That's one of the significances. And second, like I said, every name corresponds to a particular object. Not just that, there is one more aspect. Whenever you hear a name, the particular object comes to your mind, and whenever that happens, there is more or less always there is an emotion associated with that object. For example, if I say snake, if I start shouting snake, even though you are not in this room, or even though there is no snake in where you are present, still there is that slightest emotion of fear or runaway kind of feeling that comes in or manifests within your body, because it's our mind that has established, because of experience or previous knowledge, your mind has established a very strong connection between those emotions and that particular object. Okay, so whenever you hear that gets clicked or that gets triggered. Now, same if you apply to chanting Omkara. The object of Omkara or the Omkara denotes the Supreme Consciousness, who is very expansive in nature. And whenever we chant Omkara, we are supposed to chant along with remembering that expansive form of Ishvara. Only then your Om chanting becomes more meaningful. Only then it can be fruitful, you know. And the last significance that I would like to bring it to your attention would be, our mind is capable of absorbing the energy and the quality of the object that it focuses on. Okay, that's why it becomes highly important to carefully choose the object of meditation in yoga practice, or object of concentration for that matter in yoga practice, because that's why we usually ask the beginners to focus on Om practice, chanting, loud chanting, mind chanting, or focusing visually, externally focusing on Omkara. All of that is simply because the more your mind focuses on Omkara, the more it begins to grasp or grab or absorb that all those qualities, you know, inclusiveness, expansiveness, all those beautiful qualities of Omkara, which is the object of meditation. And the more your mind begins to do that, we become open-minded. We begin to overcome all those limiting emotions or old patterns that limit us to particular experience, right? That's the very reason, and that way your Om is the most easily accessible tool as well, because you can chant it louder, you can also chant it in the mind, or no chanting at all. You can simply focus on the object of Om. You know, there are different levels of practice that you can adapt just with one object, that is Om. So these are the different significances and importance of Omkara traditionally, and when it comes to your yoga practice as well. So yes, make sure whenever you're practicing Omkara, make sure it's not just a mantra or a letter that your mouth is uttering. When you're doing that, try to bring Om into your consciousness. Remember the meaning of Om so that your practice becomes fruitful. With that, we have come to the end of this video. If you have any questions regarding this subject, please make sure you leave it in the comment section. I will get back to you with the answer as soon as possible. Also, if you have any suggestions, or if you want to know about any of the concepts of yoga, please let me know that as well in the comment section, or you can DM me as well. I will try to make a video on that as soon as possible. Namaste.